first question from ABS-CBN, Ms. Joyce.
Hi, Ase. Basically, assessment lang po, baka may data na po on DepEd as to how many schools were able to participate sa on-site opening of classes sa buong bansa po. And second question ko na rin po, yung pag-iikot nyo, kamusta naman? Ano yung mga nakita po ninyong kakulangan, if there are any?
Okay. Thank you, Joyce. I cannot give you the exact number of the schools that opened on-site, but I can give you some of the regions that did not open on site because of Typhoon Guring and the rains. No, we have Region 6, Car, Region 1, Region 2, Region 3, and Batangas in Region 4A and Oriental Mindoro in Region 4B. So those are the identified areas that were reported to our DRRMS that did not open face-to-face classes today. Well, I have gone through, like, this is my 10th school, I believe. This is the 10th school out of the 14 schools. And generally, for all the 10 schools, the opening is very smooth and very orderly. No untoward incidents. All the agreements between the two superintendents have been carried out. And you can see the excitement in the eyes of the learners, in the parents. Teachers particularly. So all our classes were in place. Generally, we had a 1:43, 1:44 class size ratio, and that is within the ideal ratio for the classes, no? But most of the schools that I visited, syempre yung mga medyo limited lang ang kanilang mga space, they had to resort to double shift, but not in a way where we have the full grade levels in one shift and then the same grade levels in another shift. It is more of like a kinder grades 1, 3, and 5 in the morning, kinder grades 2, 4, and 6 in the afternoon. So they are still able to maintain the required number of time for each subject. But the only setback there would be they will have to start at 6, the earliest would be 5:30, and end at 12:30, and the other shift will start at 1, and then they will end up in around 6:30 or 7.
Sir, ma'am, patanong lang po ng office, implementation na po ng voucher program specifically for senior high school, kamusta po ito? And marami na po bang students yung napasama dun sa program?
Voucher?
Voucher program.
Hello. Nawawala yung audio ko. Yung ating voucher program, this is managed, of course, by the PAYAC, no? Yung ating Private Education Council. And because many private schools have already opened before August 29, nakapag-start na actually tayo ng enrollment sa mga, nakapag-start na tayo ng classes sa mga private schools, and marami tayong mga recipients in all of these private schools. So, yung actual recipients natin, hindi pa natin ma-establish ngayon because there are some private schools also that open together with the public schools. But we will get with our GASO kung ano na yung final count natin, but we are expecting na kung ano yung number natin last year, baka yun din yung number natin kasi hindi naman tayo nagdagdag ng additional slots, but we have the graduates of grade 12 at tapos mayroon tayong bagong entrance for grade 11 and grade 7 for this year.
How much asset yung last year nyo? Yung bang figure?
Ay, yung figure natin last year, nasa, yung amount na binibigay natin sa voucher system, including the education service contracting, nasa 32 billion tayo. Pero last year, we have around 50 plus billion because it covered 3 semesters. So, but in our, this semester, this year, 2023, we had 50 plus billion because it covers 3 semesters. Kasi nga, iba yung fiscal year at saka sa school year natin. But babalik na siya sa usual na 32 billion kasi okay na yung sa 2024 for 2 semesters.
Next question po will be coming from ED5, Sir Hannibal.
Okay, good afternoon, ASEC. Bali, nag-start na tayo ng klase ngayon, ano? Doon naman sa curriculum na binubuo ninyo, nag-start ba? At kumusta naman?
Yung ating K-10 na recalibrated or revised curriculum under the K-12 will be piloted this year in selected schools. One from NCR, one from another region in Luzon, one from the Visayas, and one from Mindanao. So we are looking at around 20 schools nationwide that will participate in the pilot study of the new curriculum. We will be consolidating all the findings and the results of this pilot so that when we implement nationwide for kinder, grades 1, 4, and 7 by 2024-2025. So it is a staggered implementation of the new curriculum because the curriculum is so designed that before you go to the next higher grade level, in each key stage, you have to master the competencies in the lower grade level. So we're starting with kinder 1, 4, 7. And then the following school year, we go to kinder 1 and 2, 4 and 5, 7 and 8, and so on until we reach grade 10.
Good afternoon po, Yus Asek. First question lang po, kamusta po yung mga schools natin na naapektuhan ng mga bagyo, like for example, Egay and Kuring? And may timeline po ba tayo kung kailan po magsisimula yung klase sa mga disaster-affected schools na ito?
Well, I can speak for Pampanga and Bulacan, heavily flooded by Typhoon Egay. As per report of the regional director, umupa na yung baha in these schools that were affected at nakapag-open na sila ng face-to-face. However, there is a report of one or two schools in Ilocos Norte or in Region 1 na tinamaan ng baha ni Egay tapos nung nagkaroon ng rains ni Goring, parang nabaha na naman siya ulit. So however, in these schools that were affected by the floods, that were not able to open on-site or face-to-face, the schools have adopted measures like shifting, modified in-school, off-school approach, and other alternative delivery modes so that they could officially open this day. So we are with the DRRMS, including our SIF, to prioritize the repairs of the damaged classrooms due to these typhoons, and our quick response fund, including the provision of temporary learning spaces, will be instituted for these cases.
Second question and my last question naman po. Of course, ayun po kayo sa mga 10 schools na affected ng Taguig Makati dispute. Kamusta naman po yung situation sa mga dispute at sa mga schools na nag-uumpugang dalawang cities ito? And to Principal Alan, kamusta naman po ang servisyo ng DepEd ngayon na it's under the now DepEd Central Office's control? There is still some questions na regarding kung ano yung mabibigyan ng Taguig, ng Makati. Kamusta naman po ang coordination between the two cities and DepEd Central Office naman po?
Good afternoon po. As far as the learner's welfare naman po ang concern, ang DepEd po, kumbaga unang-unang non-partisan naman po ang DepEd like dito sa amin sa school. So yung supplies po ay meron din naman po. At pagdating naman po sa uniform ay non-prescribed naman, wala naman pong uniform ang DepEd. So kahit ano po, inaalaw naman pong maisuot ng bata para wala na pong dagdag na pasanin yung parents na gastusin. Thank you po.
Yeah. As you know, we already have a transition team that is constituted to prepare the complete transition plan of the 14 schools. It is headed by Director R.D. Gilbert Satsad of the Bicol Region. At nakapag-meet na sila initially, two meetings already with the team, and they have already constituted 14 inventory teams that will take care of determining the property ownership of everything that is found inside these 14 schools. And I heard that starting tomorrow, they will be going around the 14 schools to start the inventory. In fact, in the schools that I visited, there are already some properties of Makati City that have been previously tagged in an earlier occasion. And as well, the DepEd has its own supply officers that will also help was part of the team for the inventory of this equipment. Pagdating naman sa mga learners materials, may nakita akong mga learners materials na galing sa Taguig, may learners materials na galing sa Makati, meron ding mga uniforms or school supplies na nakita natin dyan. Ang atin naman sa DepEd, if these are given to our learners for free, then we will not refuse them. Our learners will gladly accept them because they will be helpful in their everyday going to classes every day. So since wala naman tayong prescribed uniforms, sabi ko nga sa mga school heads, kung dalawa ang nabigay sa kanila na set of uniforms, then they can wear it in different scheduled days within the week. Kung nabigyan sila ng dalawang pares ng sapatos, well, so much the better because dalawa ang magagamit nila throughout the week or throughout the school year. So, in the DepEd's part, for as long as they are for the benefit of our learners and for the best interest of our learners and our teachers in the department, then we will not refuse such opportunities.
Next question po will be from GMA News Online, Ms. Giselle.
Good afternoon po, Asek. Kamusta naman po ang assessment natin sa teachers? Sapat po ba ito to cater to the 22.6 million learners currently enrolled? Thank you.
Well, in terms of number of teachers, actually, lagi nating sinasabi na meron tayong shortages of teachers. But if looking at the context of each region or each division, meron talaga tayong mga instances where there are schools with excess teachers and there are schools with shortage of teachers. So kailangan lang talaga sa ating mga school division office level ay makita yung teacher deployment analysis natin so that we will have equitable distribution of teachers within their areas of jurisdiction. So until then, we can only surmise that hindi ganon kadami ang ating shortage as it is apparently seen in the raw reports, but it has to be a place in the context of a proper teacher deployment analysis. Kaya tayo may mga planning offices to look into this. But we are not discounting the fact na meron pa rin tayong shortage of teachers. Kaya nga yearly, nabibigyan tayo sa budget ng around 10,000 new teaching positions annually. At ito ay ina-allocate natin at priority natin binibigyan yung mga schools with high shortage of teachers and those far-flung schools and last-mile schools na nangangailangan talaga ng mga guro.
Hi, Asek. I'm just curious, meron bang nagpaalam po na mayor from Taguig or Makati na mag-ikot today? And meron bang nakiusap sa kanila na wag na lang muna just so we can assure yung smooth na opening today?
I am not aware na merong nag-ikot na taga-local government units, but I know that in the DepEd Order 23, nakasaad talaga doon na all activities related to schools, to the operations of the schools in the 14 EMBO schools in the EMBO area should have prior approval from the Office of the Secretary. I am not aware of such. Ang nakita ko lang na talagang request from one of the cities ay yung request for the distribution, dalawa sila, distribution of learners, learning supplies or school supplies for all the learners in the area.
Which happened, hindi naman today po, no?
Hindi naman today. I think nag-start na yung distribution as early as last week, no? Nung nagkaroon tayo ng Brigada Eskwela. And then ongoing pa yung mga ibang schools sa pag-receive ng mga school supplies coming from, well, either Makati or Taguig City. Pero nakita natin, meron talaga sila.
Sorry, last na. Napansin ko lang po din na sa ibang schools po, meron pa rin pong murals sa mga classroom. I'm just wondering if paano po ba, may exemptions po ba tayo dun sa order na tanggalin na po lahat ng mga decor? Kasi particularly kanina sa isang school po, kinder. Tapos parang may alphabet sa wall. Yeah. Are we still allowing that po?
Yeah. I also noticed that in one of the schools, yung South, South Sembo. And I actually asked the principal, anong plano mo dito? Kasi unlike the other schools na posters madaling alisin, yung sa kanya nakapaint eh. It's mural talaga sa wall. Sabi niya, since nagbrigada eskwela, prioritize muna nila na i-repaint yung outside the classrooms, yung facade ng school, and then naka-pipeline na sa kanila yung pag-repaint ng kanilang mga walls sa loob ng classroom para mawala yung mga murals. And of course, she was advised really to comply with the requirement of the DepEd Order 21, and sabi naman niya, they are already planning on doing that within the next few weeks.
So, walang exemption as
well? Wala siyang exemption ngayon, no? So, it's applicable to all grade levels, kinder to grade 12.
Follow-up question po from Sir Robert Palio of
UDN. Good morning po, Asek. Nabanggit po dun sa enrollment, let's say for example dito sa EMBO schools, ano po yung instructions ninyo kasi dun sa napuntahan namin like the Pebo Elementary School, ang dami pong umahabol na late enrollees. But then, minimaintain sana nila yung 1:44, 1:45. Ngayon po, kung dadami daw, kung magdadagdag naman sila ng section, the problem is, sa sila kukuha ng teacher, lalo't may election ban tayo.
Okay. With regards to enrollment, in the public schools, it is a policy not to refuse enrollment. We cannot disenfranchise a child from an education that is given by the public schools. No? So we will accept all enrollees in our public schools. Hindi naman siguro sila ganun aabot sa around 50 or 56 just because there are two or three additional learners. They should be accommodated. And pag-transfer kasi, kung merong pumapasok, meron din kasi mga lumalabas. So antayin lang nila hanggang the next 2 weeks, magno-normalize din ang kanilang mga enrollment. But I believe hindi kami dapat nagre-refuse ng enrollment. So, yung 1:45, okay pa lang naman yan. So, they should be accepted. And this week, we will still be opening our public schools for late enrollees. We understand that na there are some enrollees whose parents may have brought them to the province for a long vacation, and they are coming back just this week. So, we will still accommodate them for late enrollment.
Hello po, Patrick Cruz from Rapier. Ask ko lang, since meron parang ongoing transition team na binubuo or nabuo yung DepEd, in terms of utilities ng mga schools sa EMBO, like electricity, water, internet, sino yung sasagot nito so far and anong plano doon?
Well, for now, I believe that the utility bills for the 14 schools are currently being paid by the city of Marikina, local government of Marikina. Sorry ha, off the record. Di pa ako nakaka-move on sa Marikina palaro eh. Yeah, it's the utility bills of the 14 EMBO schools are currently being paid by the local government of Makati City, no? But we have word from the transition team na in case if ever Taguig is also willing to cover these expenses kapag na move or na transfer sa kanila ang jurisdiction of these schools. However, if it still remains an issue, I believe the schools have enough MOOE to cover the utility bills of the entire school.
How about sir yung mga other services like yung security and yung maintenance services, kasi parang contractual sila.
Yes, I believe the utility and and security services of the 14 schools are still under it's still a contract that was that is under the city of Makati, and I heard that the contract is until December. And I was able to talk with some of the security guards in some of the schools that we visited. Sabi nga nila hanggang December pa yung kanilang kontrata. So again, kung malilipat nga sa Taguig ang ating 14 schools, willing din naman daw ang Taguig to shoulder the expenses for the contracts for utility and security services of the 14 schools. Kapag hindi rin possible sa dalawang cities, meron pa rin tayong mga limited funds from the MOE to hire job orders for security and utility.
Sir, yung mga contractual workers na ito, mga ilan to, saka possible ba siyang parang ma-renew yung contract nila given nga yung transition to
okay.
A different local government?
Let's just ask Mr. Arcilia on the number of security guards and utility para may idea tayo.
Depende rin po sa size ng school, yung deployment ng security personnel tsaka yung sa maintenance. Like in our case, dito po sa atin, meron tayong 8 security guards, then mga nasa 14 to 15 po na yung mga utility personnel po. Thank you po.
Thank you po.
May tungkol na po tayo yung DepEd doon sa kahilingan ni Mayor Abibinay na ma-retain yung tatlong schools, yung Makati Science High School and sa Fort Bonifacio Elementary School and Fort Bonifacio High School sa under DepEd Makati po.
Yeah, I was made aware of that request when I visited Makati Science, Makati Science High School. Nabanggit sa akin ng principal na parang meron silang request. Sabi ko sa kanya, i-course through proper channels mo. Sabi ko, so if the request is, for example, for Makati site to be retained with Makati City, kailangan ng kanyang request is addressed to the schools division offices. Kung si schools division superintendent ang magre-request, dadalhin niya yan request sa regional office, sa regional director, and then ibibigay na yan sa transition team. Kasi the transition team, part of the job of their transition team is also look into administrative matters like this.
Next question.
Last. Ano po yung mga major challenges po na na-encounter natin during the opening of classes po?
In the EMBO areas?
Sa lahat na po.
Sa lahat, ano pa rin eh, yung weather conditions natin in most in some of the regions, particularly in Northern Luzon, yun pa rin yung ating biggest challenge for this year. But apart from that, yung ating challenge on school facilities, hindi siya ganun ka magnified na challenge because of the institutionalization of our alternative delivery modes and blended learning modalities. So perhaps we are trying to look into the problem of shortage of facilities by shifting our intention in our attention into how we are going to redefine what learning spaces are, because in the current state of the arts, kailangan i-redefine na natin kung ano ang classroom at kung ano ang learning space, that it is no longer limited to just 4 walls of the classroom, but even the homes, your areas around your homes, areas around the schools can also serve as learning spaces. Kasi boundless na ang classrooms natin ngayon.
Last question po from Sir Ed Mendoza.
Asset, napansin ko lang po yung enrollment figures po natin for this year. Medyo mababa siya from 28 million yung last year. Ngayon, 22.4. Bakit po ganun po kababa? And are we expecting the same figure as the days progresses po?
Well, we are expecting around that same number. If we are to say na yung nag-graduate na grade 12 ay kapareho ng number na papasok na grade 11. But also, we are looking into the first day of classes. Our number is 22.9 million. No, as of today. So this number, we are hoping will increase. Kasi alam mo, yung number na binigay namin is a running number, and it is coming from our learner information system, which is collated at the central office through uploading coming from all the schools all over the country. So alam natin na may mga kahirapan tayo sa mga other schools to upload their enrollment. So until ma-complete yung enrollment ng ating mga LIS coordinators or EBIS coordinators sa mga school levels, ma-complete yan, makikita natin yung total picture. While we have not yet reached an expected or assumed 28 million from both public and private, we are looking at an increasing trend from today until Friday. Kasi by that time, makapag-settle down ng mga schools, all the advisors and LIS coordinators will be able to upload their data on our system para makapture na siya.
For context lang po, ASEC, hanggang kailan po ang enrollment?
Ang enrollment, pwede pa tayo hanggang Friday or Saturday, pwede pa tayong mag-enroll, no? Pero historically in the department, umaabot tayo ng first 2 weeks of the classes na open tayo sa enrollment.
Thank you.
ASEC, may pahabol lang. Kasi nabanggit nyo kanina yung mechanics dun sa first and second shift. Mayroon bang option na magkaroon ng third shift kung sakaling na talagang highly congested yung area?
We do have in Metro Manila, I believe, some schools that are still in 3 shifts. Yung same din, nag-start ng 5 to 5.30, tapos nag-end sila ng 7 o'clock. However, kung 3 shifts kasi yan, nasi-shorten yung time. Yung contact time with learners, nasi-shorten. Kaya as much as possible, we are telling Metro Manila in the schools na naka-3 shifts, kung pwedeng gawa ng paraan para maging 2 shifts na lang sila. Para at least ma-retain mo yung contact hours required, yung time allotment per subject area, ma-retain natin. While also addressing the issue on magkakaroon ba ng enough number of teachers that will teach for 3 shifts. And it's going to be a nightmare for the preparation of class program if that were the case.
Kasi could you know how much na, or how many po ng mga schools na nagkakaroon ng tatlong shifts?
Yan yung kinokulate pa natin ng operations ngayon. So we already have deployed a Google Sheet that will take how many schools are in single, double, and triple all over the country. Siguro by the end of the week, we will give you that exact number. Ay, ako si Joyce. Papalas-las lang yan, pero mamayang gabi tatawag yan.
Kaya habang sa ere, Joyce.
May papasa po ko mamaya kay Robert.
Okay, sure.
Hindi, ASIC, clarify ko lang, yung mga nabanggit nyo kaninang regions na hindi nag-on-site, meron po doon region 4A, may mga iba po na not necessarily Northern Luzon.
Central Luzon.
Okay. Region 3, Region 2, CAR, Batangas,
yes,
and Oriental Mindoro in Region 4B.
At lahat po
may mga suspension of classes sila by the local governments.
And then, nabanggit po kanina nung isang kung napuntahan na school sa Rizal High School.
Di pa ako nagpupunta doon. Last destination ko yun. Ay, ikaw nagpunta. Okay.
Pero may nabanggit po kasi sila na pagdating sa senior high, medyo limited na po kasi sila in terms of facilities kasi very specific yung kumbaga facilities nila for the strands. Ang ginagawa po nila, dahil hindi na nila kayang i-accommodate, they stop accepting students but they endorse them sa nearby public schools. So okay lang naman po yun. It, kumbaga sa DepEd, hindi siya quote-unquote rejecting students.
Hindi naman, kasi kung talagang hindi na siya kasya, hindi mo siya maisiksik talaga, nagsasuffer naman yung quality ng instruction. So long as that accepting school will refer it directly to another school that is also within the area at hindi magkakaroon ng additional expense yung bata in going to either school. So basta i-assist lang ang mga bata to move to the nearby school na walang additional expense. Yeah.
Asik, habol lang po, sorry. Nabanggit nyo po yung transition team with the EMBO schools. Paano po kaya natin to i-reconcile doon sa statement naman ni DILG Secretary Abalos this morning na ang sinasabi niya, kailangan ng writ of execution bago kumilos?
Oh well, that is a legal matter that is outside the function of the transition team to decide on. Basta ang transition team natin nakafocus lang siya sa education, sa schools, sa delivery of the curriculum, learners' materials, plantilla of DepEd personnel, the fiscal management of the schools, and that's it. Outside of that, that is the way, that's already beyond the authority given to the transition team.
Okay.
Thank you.